This week, more than 1,000 of the world's best novelists, journalists, and poets have joined together to write out a single letter addressed to the heads of Amazon.
No group of authors as diverse or prominent as this has ever come together before in support of a single cause. Collectively, we have sold more than 1 billion books. Amazon's tactics have caused us profound anguish and outrage.
It is just the latest page in the long and poorly plotted story of the war between Amazon and the book publisher Hachette, a war that's forced book lovers and bookmakers to pick sides over how and what we get to read. While the anti-Amazon group Authors United has attracted heavyweights like Stephen King and John Grisham, the other side has more than 8,000 Amazon authors urging the publisher Hachette to give in to the online retailers' demands. So which one is right, or by that I mean slightly less than the wrong? Well, after 6 months of bickering and arguing and generally behaving like jerks, it's finally come to this. Ladies and gentlemen, this is The Great Literary Jerk-Off. Okay, first off, this whole thing involves Amazon stopping people from reading books. And for an organisation that calls itself the world's biggest bookstore, that's a flawed policy.
They began to hurt authors. And what hurts one of us hurts all of us.
To penalise Hachette, Amazon have delayed shipping times, they've refused pre-orders, they've doubled the price of certain books, and in some cases, they've left out the button that lets users buy things. In actively stopping people from reading, Amazon have joined an exclusive club that includes the Nazis, the Khmer Rouge, and Gaston from Beauty and the Beast.
Belle, it's about time you got your head out of those books and paid attention to more important things. Like me.
Okay, surely Amazon is the jerk here.
You're a jerk!
But hold on, the reason Hachette are being targeted is because they're refusing to lower the price of their digital products. So a lot of their physical books and their electronic books cost the exact same amount, which makes no sense. I mean, when Domino's finally figure out how to sell a pizza without the bread, no one's going to be happy to pay top dollar for their puddle of tomato sauce and cheese.
It's a top-selling author. Do we want that in here?
No, we want bottom-selling authors.
The literary publisher often charges about $15 for books, regardless of whether or not there's an E at the front. Meanwhile, Amazon has calculated that book sales increase by 16% if all of the prices are dropped to a uniform $10. Really, by hanging on to unjustifiably high prices, Hachette is hurting both the authors selling books and the customers buying them. Clearly jerky behaviour.
The jerk store called. They're running out of you.
So, Amazon gave us cheaper books, but at what cost? I mean, obviously a cheaper one. But I mean more in a moral sense. Amazon have become nothing short of a bully over the past year, and now they're throwing around more weight than a pole dancing sumo wrestler. From manipulating its search algorithms so that retailers are hard to find, to releasing apps that let users scan products in real stores so they can buy them online. Yes, Amazon have done everything it can to undercut its competition. Which would be fair enough, were it not for the fact that Amazon sell everything and are competing with everyone.
What do you mean everyone?
But it's with books that Amazon gets most aggressive. See, right now, the company is responsible for about 65% of all ebooks that get sold each year, and 90% of all audiobooks. And you don't get that kind of market share without jerking it up a bit.
I'm going with Jerkstore! Jerkstore is the line!
Of course, book publishers know you can't just be mad at something because it's a better, more successful version of you. Otherwise, I would still be allowed to throw things at Charlie Pickering's house. The truth is that publishers like Hachette, who are suffering through price fixing and bully tactics, are getting the exact same treatment they used to dish out to bookstores. Amazon and Hachette are now two middlemen in an industry that may only require one. At the end of the day, no matter how important books may well be, what you've got here is a choice between a billion-dollar monopoly and a billion-dollar cartel. No matter which way you read it, it's jerk versus jerk.